empowertoolswiththread.com. That's my blog. I am going to do an unboxing video for you of my new Brother ScanNCut SDX 325. Now, the reason I got this ScanNCut is because it has the ability to talk to the Brother Luminaire embroidery machine, sewing and embroidery machine combo. And I want to be able to cut out machine applique designs and get the fabric cut out using the ScanNCut by just sending it directly from the Luminaire to the ScanNCut itself. So I thought I would take you through this. The tape is still on it. We're gonna do this cold, okay? But this isn't my first rodeo. I've had the ScanNCut CM650, which is the wireless older machine, and then the ScanNCut SDX225. I've taken that ScanNCut down to our vacation house down at the coast, and I've brought home the CM650. It's actually here in the luggage that came with this one, and I'm gonna put that up for sale. So let's go through first of all, and I will show you what came with the purchase of this ScanNCut SDX325. It came with a project book. This is not like a playbook, but it is a project book that just gives you some ideas of things you could do. And you need to get some accessories for some of these things, but it just has ideas and whatnot. Most of it is for paper and heat transfer vinyl. Not my jam, I'm a fabric crafter, so everything that I use the ScanNCut for the most part, 99% of it is for fabric. But it did come with a little book of projects. And I got this from allbrands.com. And All Brands is based out of Louisiana, and they've got stores in Louisiana and Texas, and they can send ScanNCuts all over the country. So if you are interested in getting a ScanNCut, be sure to check them out online, compare prices and whatnot, because every once in a while, different dealers will throw in different deals. So I got that project book, and then I also received this luggage piece right here, and it has ScanNCut. Let's see what it's got. It's got ScanNCut DX embroidered right down there in the corner. So this is a nice tote bag. My old CM650 is in here. I need to get it cleaned up and all the mats and everything. This is perfect size to carry this ScanNCut, and then I also put my mats in there too. So it holds everything just perfectly. They're about the same size, the CM models and the SDX models. Got some scissors here, and I'm just gonna go through and open up the tape. So exciting. I love new toys. Don't you love new toys? Somebody just emailed me and said they bought a brand new Brother Stellaire. She was all excited. That's such fun. Opening it up, you get a little package right here. It has a book in it that gives you another project you can do, another project thing. Let's get started. And this book right on the top is just full of ideas of very cool things that you can do. And it has some very basic operations. Let's use the scanning functions, and each page has a bunch of different languages on it. So this thing's only a couple of pages long. That's how simple it is to go ahead and get this thing all set up. But it has on page 7, there is machine setup right here, and it gives you all the instructions of what you need to do. Okay, and then in here is a booklet that has got parts and warranty and all that kind of stuff. So there's that. Nothing else in there? Nope. Okay, we've got another box right here, and this box has, if I can figure out how to open it. That has the power cord in it. I'm gonna need that, right? I'm gonna show you when I get this thing unpackaged, how to set it up, get it connected with your laptop, and get it connected to the Brother Canvas, which is a free online design area for you. And then in here, it also comes with looks like two different mats. We have the purple standard tack mat, and there is a piece of blue paper in here that you can make that very first little project. It's a little blue box with a crown. And so you've got a piece of sample paper in there that you would use with the standard tack mat. The mats between the CM models and the SDX models are different. The CM models have arrows on both ends. It doesn't matter which way the mat goes in, but on the SDX model, it does matter. And there's only a single arrow at the top of the mat, and the mat can only go in one way. So then it also comes with the gold fabric mat. So this is the SDX 325. There's not an F in this number, but it did come with a gold fabric mat. The fabric mat is designed for you to be able to use and cut fabric without any kind of substrate on the back. I'll give you a word of warning though. If it were me, before I ever put a piece of fabric on this, I would take this mat and I would get it a little less tacky by pressing it on a t-shirt of some sort to get it a little less sticky. You can always put the sticky back by spraying on some Totally Awesome, LA's Totally Awesome. You can get it Dollar General or Dollar Tree and cleaning it up again and get all that extra little fuzz off. But the sticky on this is really, really sticky, and it can distort your fabric when you go to pull it off. Okay. I like cutting my fabric on my low tack mats anyway. I have low tack mats, the turquoise colored low tack mats. That's what I like to cut my fabric on now. All right, and I'm just gonna pull this up. And there you are, so pretty. There we go, pull this out. There we go. And we've got in here, we've got some substrate in here that you would actually use to put onto the back of fabric. It looks a lot like Hot Fix adhesive, but it's not labeled as such. So, and here we go. Look at that. Now this machine has some cute little designs on the front. It is not a Disney. It doesn't have a D in the number. So it's just got little flowers right here. Okay, we've got a card that is taped to the top of the machine. This is a serial number for My Connection. My Connection is a new utility interface that allows the SDX 325 models and higher, meaning like 325 or 330 or anything else that comes after that, to be able to talk to the Brother Luminaire. So this is special. You need to keep this because this is what you're going to use to connect your Scan-A-Cut to your sewing machine. Okay, I'm going to open this up and pull off this paper right here. And it tells you in here what's in what side. They've put little stickers here to show that there is a pouch in here with blades and a pouch with markers. Take that off. Okay, I'm gonna take off all of this tape. Get this out. That's just to protect the insides. You wanna remove that. And then in here, these open up. And here's a little pouch. You have two blades in here. You have a black standard blade and a gold fabric blade. So the blade didn't come in the holder. And then also in this pouch, you have a spatula and you have a stylus. And for right now, I'm gonna put these right here, but I normally put a Command little shaving cup for your bathroom. I normally put that right here on the side, and that holds all of my goodies for my Scan-A-Cut. I'm gonna go ahead and just put the black blade into the holder. And all you need to do is pull off the little cap, and it is ready to go. I'm gonna put the cap into here, and I'm just gonna pop this into here. This little lever goes up and down right there. It springs up. I'm just gonna drop it in until it can't go any further and lock that in place. Open this half, And in here, you have another plastic bag that has a pen holder and a couple of pens. You've got blue, which is the water erasable pen, and purple, which is the air erasable pen. So this entire Scan-A-Cut is really geared toward cutting and marking fabric. Has us in mind to use this with our embroidery machines. Put that up. Okay. So up here, this just folds up. There's your screen. And you've got a little tray up here. On the side, there is a lever marked 1 and 2. And right now it is on the 1. And if you're ever cutting something that's rather thick, you would pop this up to the 2. And the machine will tell you if something is too thick. And it'll stop and it'll back out and say, hey, you need to change this to a 2. That's what it's talking about. Normally, you'll just leave it on a 1 if you're cutting quilting cottons or anything that is, you know, like a piece of felt or any fabric or anything like that. And then back here, there is a tray. And you can pull this tray out right here, like this. And that just keeps your mat from dragging off, falling over the back if your table isn't quite large enough. If you ever need to clean your glass inside or the mirror, you can pull out this entire piece right here. There's a way to do that. I'm not going to do it right now. I have never had to clean my mirror, so I'm just going to leave this like it is. So you'll plug in your Scan-A-Cut right over here. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is turn on the Scan-A-Cut with using the power button. Just hold it down for a second. And you'll see the screen come to life and let it do its initialization. It'll start flashing some pictures at you. This is so exciting, I love this. Oh, there we go, it's switched. The pictures are switching now, so it's gone through its thing. I'm gonna touch it. And it says the carriage will move to the initial position. Keep your hands away from the carriage. I'm gonna tell it okay. Very good. Now the first thing we need to do is to set it up. And down here in the bottom corner, there is an image of a wrench, and that is our setting. So I'm gonna touch the wrench. And I need to scroll through these until I find the network settings, because the first thing we have to do is to connect the Scan-A-Cut to my home network so it knows that it's on the internet, and then we can connect it to my connection on the sewing machine. First things first, so let me scroll through here. You can scroll through using the single arrow, and we've got cut speed, cut pressure. I'm gonna keep going. Half cut, cut pressure, all through this stuff. It's probably near the end. And we have auto shutdown, buzzer sound, all kinds of stuff. Here is the number of my Scan-A-Cut and the version of the software. It's telling me that. Network. We've got a button right here that says network, so I'm going to touch that. And it says WLAN enable. That's wireless LAN, local area network, enable. And right now it's off. And I'm going to tell it on. I want it connected to my local area network. I'm going to do a setup wizard. And I am going to choose Thompson because that is my home network. It actually found a couple. So it's got Thompson, it has Yeedy, that's my wireless vacuum cleaner. Wills Casa, I have no idea what that is. That's probably my neighbor. So I'm hitting Thompson, that's my last name, that's the name of my network, and I'm gonna tell it okay. Now it wants to know my network access code to be able to log on to my network. So I'm gonna do that. That's the wireless access code, Wi-Fi code. It says apply settings. I'm going to tell it yes. So now it is connecting to my wireless local area network. That's my Wi-Fi. Connection to WLAN. Specify the Canvas workspace setting in order to send cutting data between Canvas workspace and the machine. So I'm going to touch next. So that was successful connecting it to the wireless network. Next. Thank you. Now it says, register the connection between Canvas Workspace account and the machine in order to send data back and forth. So I'm going to tell it next. Now it has given me a number to put into, down here at the bottom, register your machine at Canvas Workspace. So I'm going to go on my laptop right now. Okay, I'm going to log in to my Canvas Workspace. It's canvasworkspace.brother.com. And I'm log in. And I like to use the online version versus the local version on the desktop. You can certainly download the local version, but I'm going to do the online right now. And I need to set up a new ScanaCut and attach it to this. So I'm going to go into my account, and it says machine registration right here in the upper right corner. So I'm going to touch that. Here is register a new machine. I'm going to touch this, input the machine number, and that's the number that I see on the screen. And I'm scrolling up and right there. So let me do that. You want to put in the dash, and I'm going to tell it okay. Here's a PIN code. Now I'm going to touch okay on the machine, and I'm going to input the PIN code that I see on my screen. And that's just to confirm that these two are talking to each other. By clicking OK, following information will be sent to Brother Server to pair your machine with your Canvas Workspace login ID. I'm going to tell it OK. And it's processing. The Canvas Workspace setting has been specified. We are good. I'm going to tell it OK. Awesome. That's great. And it recognizes my Canvas Workspace login ID, Becky Lee Thompson, and that's perfect. I'm done. You can see my wireless little radar waves are right up here. The wireless is set up. Look how easy that was. Zero problems with this. I'm going to hit back, and now I'm going to touch OK. And we are back to home. And I'm on my screen here. I'm going to touch OK. And now I see that third scan and cut. Now I want to connect the scan and cut to the Luminaire. I'm going to need the little paper that was on top of the machine with the code for that. All right, I'm over here at the Brother Luminaire, and I'm going to go into the settings icon, and I'm going to go through my pages until I find my network settings. So here it says scan and cut my connection, and in order to get that to work, I have to touch the certification button. Certify upgrade kit, press kit number to certify. I've already got kit 1 and kit 2 in this. This is the XP1, and I've done both of the upgrades, so essentially it's an XP2 now. I'm going to touch scan and cut, and it wants online machine certification. So I'm going to touch that, and I've got to go through some terms and conditions. I agree. And now I need to input the number that came inside of this little paper that was attached to the top of the scan and cut. And there is a sticker at the bottom of the page right under my thumb that has, certification was successful. Please restart the sewing machine to send data to your scan and cut machine, restart your machine and register your machine. Already done. So I'm gonna turn the machine off and restart it. Okay, I'm going to go back into my settings and go to my network page. And I've got scan and cut my connection with a check mark next to it. That's great. That's exactly what I'm looking for. So we are all done. Everything is happy here. I'm going to tell it okay. All right. So I'm ready to start using my scan and cut directly with my Luminaire now. Okay, you guys, I hope this was helpful. I will be doing more tutorials to show you how the scan and cut and the Luminaire talk to one another and how it's going to cut out fabric applique for my quilts. I can't wait to get started with it. Please subscribe, please give me a thumbs up, and we will talk to you soon. Go sew something. Bye.